What was that?
That is an ambulance.
What was that?
That was a car tire.
What was that?
I have no idea what that was.
New York City.
Did we just move here?
I think we did.
You think Josh is gonna be okay? This is my crocodile, Lyle. Please take good care of him.
How are you guys? Will
Speck.
Josh Gordon, it's absolutely amazing to be able to speak to you guys today. Okay, so I went into the movie expecting to watch a lighthearted film about a singing crocodile, which I did get, but I actually got more than that. The idea that a lot of people go through their life scared, and sometimes it takes you finding that one person to really push you out of your comfort zone in order to make you feel more whole. What deeper messages did you guys want people to get from this film? Or am I well off? You can tell me. No, babe, it's just a single.
Well, I would say your answer is our answer. So congratulations.
I mean, I think for us, you know, the themes of this movie were always, and the book really, were always what drew us to this project. And I think, you know, for us, for Will and I, it was also about everything you just said, but it was also about, you know, not being afraid of the other, you know, not judging a book by its cover. So Lyle is really a sort of intimidating, you know, kind of animal, but underneath he's soulful and sweet. And he, like you said, unlocks you in ways you never expected. So it's really a movie about love and about giving love and receiving love.
I love that. And I want to know a little bit more about how the collaboration with Shawn Mendes came about. Did you guys see the animated crocodile and was like, yep, that is Shawn. That looks like him. You know, that looks like it could sound like him. Or like, how did it come about?
Well, it was a little bit of both. We had developed that character a little bit, but not fully. We were waiting to put in the piece of who was going to sing his voice. And once we decided to cast Shawn, which was very early on, he helped shape that character because we recorded Shawn in a booth and we filmed those sessions and then gave those to our animators so that the character could actually reflect a lot of the soul and essence of who Shawn is.
At the top of the world tonight, when no one ever has to hide.
I love that. And that's such an interesting like piece of information to know about the process. So I'm no actor, but I can only imagine how hard it must be for the actors to basically be working with a CGI main character. First of all, how did they navigate that?
Well, you know, one of the things that was really important to Will and I was that the movie feel real and that you believe that he was really in the scenes with those actors. So we built all the sets for real. There wasn't a lot of set extension. And then we had a stand-in, a person who played Lyle on set, just so that the actors could have something physical to interact with and the camera crews could have something to film. And that really added a level of realism. And then, like Will said, we painted that person out and we made the character that we created with Shawn Mendes really fill that space. And I think that is what gives it believability.
And you know what? Credit to the stand-in. Clearly, he did a really good job. Okay, smoke and mirrors and everything like that. But does the stand-in wear like the all-black suit with like the dots?
Yeah, he had a funny big head that looked like Lyle and a tail. Because you know, you don't want the character to walk through a door that Lyle couldn't walk through. So he was sort of awkward on set, but it was also sometimes made us laugh.
Because this is CGI for dummies, right? Me. I don't know if you're joking about that part, by the way, or if you're being dead serious. I have no idea.
Well, you'll never know.
I will personally probably never know. That is true. So from your directorial debut of Blades and Glory over a decade ago, back in like 2017, to now, Lyle Lyle Crocodile, what is the biggest lesson in film that you could share with me?
Find a partner.
That's nice. That's sweet. is that it? Just find a partner?
Well, yeah. I mean, it's, you know, it's a really lonely and difficult process sometimes making a movie, and there's a lot in front of you, and if you can find somebody that you can collaborate with, whether it be a writer or producer or co-director, it can really help make that process achievable, and you can actually you know, reach for very high goals and achieve them, we think.
Also, if you know, if anybody ever disagrees with one of us, we've always got the other one to back each other. So
exactly.
Yeah, you've got each other's back. Perfect. Literally. Well, thank you guys so much for speaking with me today.
Thank you.
Thank
very
you. And
much.
Thanks for checking out the movie and for being so astute with what you're picking up about it. We
go
really
see it and go see it in movie theaters.
Yeah. Oh, I've been shaking. I love it when you go crazy. You take all my
inhibitions. Baby, there's nothing holding me back. Hide them. We have to show people that they don't have to be afraid.
Oh, you got a crocodile on a motorcycle?